Welcome back to Angels and Light Tarot. Thank you for joining me for your monthly general message for July 2021. Now, this is not a love message, but if love does come up, we will definitely be sure to take a peek into it. All right, angels, we're looking for positive energy for Virgo's general message for July 2020. Angels, what are the messages for Virgo? Angels, we need something positive for lovely, lovely Virgo. May we have one more, please? Just one more from this deck. There we go. All right, moving on to, yes, my mama's deck. Yes, yes, yes. Angels, thank you. High vibrations is what we are looking for. Yes, yes, and yes. Now, let's go ahead and add one from the Dragon's deck, and we always know that the Dragon's deck is right side up so that we can get all of the positive energy out of the message. Come on, angels, positive energy, please. Positive energy. Oops, remember, what goes on the floor stays on the floor. Angels, messages for lovely, lovely Virgo. Thank you. Angels, come on, angels. What's going on for Virgo? Thank you. And thank you. I'm just going to keep on shuffling, aren't we? All right, angels. Let's get some messages for Virgo. Thank you. There we go. Now, we're going to add one from the Buddha deck. Yes, to get a spiritual message for the month of July. We have beauty. Yes, there is beauty all around, Virgo. All right, so major theme for the month is the Fool card reversed with the Joker. Consistent, Eight of Spades, and the Four of Clubs. So it feels like with the Fool card, you're thinking you're going somewhere. You're wanting to go somewhere new. Unexpectedly, you don't. I feel like with the Joker, there is something. It's a surprise. That's all I'm saying. It is a surprise. And this surprise is the gift that keeps on giving. With the consistent, there is much power behind this. And it makes you think, you know what? Okay, I got it. I'm not going anywhere. I got it, okay? Now, I feel like it's a sense of surprisingly staying right where you are. And it feels like it's not a challenge to stay right where you are. I feel like there's power in staying right where you are. And guess what? You know it. Okay. All right. Now, when we look at the recent past, we had the Death card. Yes. With the Three of Spades, Defense, King of Hearts, and the Two of Clubs. So in the recent past, I feel with the Death card, there was a change. This change, I feel like it was brutal. Yes, it was a brutal change. And I feel with the Three of Spades, it absolutely drove you crazy. I'm going to say crazy. But with the Defense card, I am picking up, even though I feel like whatever was happening in the recent past, I see you standing up for yourself. You did stand up for yourself. With the King of Hearts, you kept your composure. Yes, you did. And you tried with the Two of Clubs to talk it out peacefully. All right? That was in the recent past. Now, in the middle of the month, we have the Nine of Pentacles reversed with the Six of Hearts, Success, Ten of Spades, and the Nine of Clubs. So in the middle of the month, financially speaking, you don't feel as empowered as you had in the past. Yeah. Yeah, with the Six of Hearts, I feel like this is a feeling that you have. This is just a feeling. Check in with it. See if it's just a feeling that you are having. Because success is definitely for you in the middle of the month. There's a lot of double success. Yes, the 10 of spades. There's a lot of success. There's also a lot of work around, but it's success. With the 9 of clubs, I hear you talking about all the work that must be done. Now, I feel like financially speaking, or in your values or things of that nature, I feel like there's a part of you that feels like there's not enough. There's a part of you that feels like you're lacking in some department in your life, right? But not really. There's actually more. There's actually abundance around you in the middle of the month. So, yes, and I hear you coming to terms with that. Like, you know what? I'm okay. I'm really okay. All right, now, and there's beauty in that, Virgo. Now, when we look at the end of the month, we have the Page of Cups. Yes, we do. With the Five of Hearts, opinions. Five of Hearts again, and the Four of Hearts. So by the end of the month, someone is offering you love, Virgo. This person, this energy that's offering you love, be mindful of this energy with the, I'm just gonna say it. There's a fish in that cup. That's some fish you kind of love. So be mindful of who is offering you love. It might be a new suitor that comes around, but remember there's a fish in there, okay? It might be your children coming to you asking you for something, and they're so sweet and they're so kind and they're so loving, and you're like, okay, all right, there's something that they want, right? With the Five of Hearts, I feel you will change your mind about this love that is coming into your world. A lot of people have opinions about this. A lot of people are watching you, Virgo, to see what you do with this. Your feelings may change a few times by the end of the month in reference to this love. With the Four of Hearts, I see that you do get a hold of your emotions and you control your emotions about this energy. Now, for some of you, remember, this is not a love reading, but for some of you, yes, this is romantic love coming into your world. But be mindful of this love that is, yes, the beauty of it is you're not really gonna jump into this. You're not, because I feel like, I don't know why, but I feel like you kind of know that this person isn't the right person for you. And you know people are going to talk and talk and talk. Gossip, I'm just going to say gossip about this. And I feel like you kind of get control of it. Like, yeah, I hear you saying, yeah, that person wasn't right for me. Now, let's say this is a friend or a child or a parent for that matter, or a friend, cousin, brother, sister, coming to you, throwing love on top of you. And you're like, why is this person loving me up? What's coming next? What's coming next? The Four of Hearts is telling me that you're going to find out what's coming next, right? Now, let's take a peek, shall we, at your bonus. You have the Four of Wands reversed with the Six of Swords, Seven of Spades with the Gratitude, the Jack of Diamonds, and the King of Diamonds. So I feel like, you know, home life, family life, it's okay. It's okay where you live, where your bricks and sticks are. It's okay. It could be better. But I feel like there's something. You're thinking about leaving a situation. You're thinking about leaving, period, if that makes sense. It might even be to go on a trip for some of you. Have faith in this endeavor. I feel like you will be grateful that you did have faith. Sometimes we move forward and we're not, we want to know the answers, okay? We want to know, well, what's going to happen? Well, in this case, you can't. It's not for you. It's for you to step out in faith. Because wherever you are, it feels like it's okay, but you could be somewhere different. You could be somewhere better, okay? Now, with the Jack of Diamonds, I feel like there's something about going in this direction that doesn't feel very... It doesn't feel like the grown-up thing to do, but with the King of Diamonds, I know that you will see exactly what it is. I know that you will take control of this situation, and that is the beauty of it. Wherever you are going to, whatever, I feel like I said, some of you are leaving a job, Okay, some of you are leaving a home, and it's for you to step out in faith and not worry how it's going to work, what job you're going to be at, or what home you're going to go to. Is it all going to work out? Yeah, the angels are saying, have faith that it will work out. Yes, there will be some shenanigans with this Jack of Diamonds, but with the King of Diamonds, this is nothing that you, Virgo, cannot handle. You can handle this. So wherever you're going, whatever you're doing, there's going to be a little bit of bump in the road here and there, but you got this, okay? You really, really have this. Now, this seems like an oxymoron here, because the major theme is saying you're not going anywhere. Mm-mm. But the Joker card says, yeah, somebody threw a monkey wrench in your program. Somebody threw a monkey wrench. And I feel like with the consistent, that going, that staying, that going, yeah, you're going and you're gonna go. You're gonna go. There's power in this new adventure. And you know that there is power in this. So if you need to pack your bags, pack your bags. If you need to, I'm going to leave this like this. I feel like, yes, it is okay to pack your bags, pack whatever it is you're packing. I feel like, or leaving a situation. For some of you, you are leaving a situation behind. I feel like for some of you, you might be leaving a love behind that, yeah, that was fishy. Yeah, that was fishy. The beauty of it all is you get the opportunity to leave, yes, things behind this month. So I'm gonna leave it there. And there, and with this king, yeah, you have the ability to handle all of this. You have the ability to move into a new direction, okay? At the beginning of the month, you're thinking, I'm not going anywhere. By the middle of the month, you're like, I'm out of here. All right, so I'm going to leave it there. I send you joy, namaste, and much, much love sent your way.